Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo into glamorous portraits by adding a variety of sexy skin glows you often see in fashion magazines, posters, and record album covers. Open a photo you'd like to use. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. The first thing we should do is to convert your image into a smart object so any effects we give it will be non-destructive. Click the icon at the top right corner of the Layers panel and choose Convert to Smart Object. I'll show you the fastest and simplest way to give it a glamorous skin glow. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Diffuse Glow. We won't add any graininess because we want to keep our image as smooth as possible. The glow amount controls how bright the glow is, and the clear amount determines how much of the image is covered by the glow. For this particular image, I'll set the glow at 1 and the clear amount at 6. Keep in mind, depending on the size, resolution, and characteristics of your photo, you should experiment with these amounts until you get just the right combination that looks good to you. Then, click OK. Click the adjustment layer icon and choose Vibrance. Click the Clip to Layer icon, which clips or restricts the adjustment layer to affect only the one layer beneath it in the Layers panel. Slide the Vibrance all the way to the right. As you can see when I toggle back and forth, we now added a soft skin glow to our image, and we did it with just one adjustment layer and one filter. Now, I'll show you some other ways to achieve beautiful, glamorous effects, but this time with a bit more complexity. First, let's group the last effect into its own folder. To do this, shift-click on the thumbnail of the middle layer to highlight it, and press Ctrl or Command-G. Click off the eyeball next to the folder to hide it. Click Layer 0 to make it active, and make a copy of it. Change the blend mode to overlay. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Reduce the view until you can see most of the face. Adjust the radius amount so you can barely make out the eyes, nose, and mouth. Then click OK. Hide the layer and make the bottom layer active. We want to make a selection just around the skin. To do this, go to Select and Color Range. Make sure Selection is ticked. If you're working on CS5 or earlier, choose Sampled Colors and adjust the fuzziness until you see that most of the skin is selected with as little of the rest of the image showing. Then click OK. If you're working on CS6 or later, choose Skin Tones. Photoshop automatically finds the skin and adjusts the color range to get the best selection, then click OK. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Open your brush tool and choose a medium-sized brush and a hardness of 0%. Make sure the opacity and flow are 100% each. Now, paint over areas that aren't part of the skin. To remove areas of the quick mask, make your foreground color white by pressing X on your keyboard or clicking this icon. Now, brush over areas of the skin that the quick mask covered, as well as the lips. To enlarge or reduce the size of the brush, press the right or left bracket keys. Now, brush over those areas. To paint back in areas, press X again to make the foreground color black. Make sure you have the eyes and eyebrows filled in. When you're done, press Q again to revert the quick mask back into a selection. Make the middle layer visible and active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. As I turn the layer mask off and on, you can see the difference. Next, we'll make the eye color more attention-getting. First, make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Then, make a copy of it. Make sure black is your foreground color and click on the Quick Mask icon so we can brush in a quick mask. Now, carefully brush over just the irises. Press Q to make it into Selections, and then click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Click the photo to make it active, and click the Adjustment Layer icon. Choose Vibrance, and click the Clip to Layer icon to restrict the adjustment layer to just the irises. Slide the vibrance and the saturation all the way to the right. The last effect can be achieved simply by using a filter that we used earlier. First, make another composite snapshot, and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Use Diffuse Glow again with the same settings you used earlier. To intensify the effect, press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter. Have fun transforming regular photos into glamorous, sexy portraits. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.